بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. قل أعوذ برب الناس، مالك الناس، إله الناس، من شر الوسواس الخناس، الذي يوسوس في صدور الناس من الجنة والناس. Meaning, in the name of Allah, the most gracious, the most merciful. Say, I seek refuge with the Lord of An-Nas, the King of An-Nas, the God of An-Nas, from the evil of the whisperer who withdraws, who whispers in the breast of An-Nas, of Jinn and An-Nas. So this is the last surah in the Quran, surah number 114, surah An-Nas. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, first ayah is meaning, say I seek refuge with the Lord of An-Nas. The King of An-Nas is second, and the third is the God of An-Nas are connected and are one as one. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala here is emphasizing his attributes. First is attribute of Rabbaniyya, of Lordship, as he is the one who is the Rabb of mankind. The second is that he is a Malik, he is a sovereign, sovereign over his creation and everything that he creates. And the third and final of these three ayat which are connected is that he, subhanahu wa ta'ala, is the Ilah of An-Nas. Ilah is something which is worshipped. Worshipped by heart, by tongue, and by lips. Something which is loved and completely person which loves that, which is worshipped with complete submission and complete obedience. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he's emphasizing, he saying that he is the one who is supposed to, is the one who is Ilah. He is the one which is supposed to be worshipped by An-Nas. As he is the one who is a Rabb of An-Nas, and he is the one who is the Malik of An-Nas. Now, here in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying An-Nas. Is it that An-Nas is only the man, or it includes in it the creation of al-jinn kind also? When scholars, when they discuss this particular word here, An-Nas, they say also that here, as a majority, they say that here also the creation of the jinn is included in it. As it is reported from Ibn Jarir al-Tabari, rahimahullah, in his tafsir, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah al-Jinn, when he used in one ayat, he said, رجال من الجن. And here, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is talking about that some men from, they used to seek protection, and they used to seek help from people of al-jinn. And here, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what is the point? He said, رجال من الجن. Men from the jinns has been used in reference to them. So it is not strange for the word An-Nas to be applied to them also. Inshallah, here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the surah An-Nas, when he mentioned his three attributes, his lordship, his sovereignty, and his ilahiyah, that he is the one to be worshipped only, he then proceeds in the fourth ayah, when he is actually telling us to what we are seeking refuge in him. From what? He said, "Min sharri waswasil khannas," meaning from the evil of the whisperer who withdraws. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala here is teaching us the adab of a dua, how to proceed with our call to him. Because here first he is telling us, ask Allah with his attributes, with his names, in order that he subhanahu wa ta'ala respond to us. to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala belongs the Mathal Mu'ala, the best example. But here we want to say, for example, to make it closer to us, to understand this. If someone comes to court of some great king in this dunya life, so he wants to ask something from him, he's not going to immediately approach and say, I want this, I want that from you. No. First he's going to be humble, he's going to try to have some means of approach to him to have better benefit. So he's going to say, oh, you great, respected king, sovereign of this and that country. And after he mentioned his attributes, then he's going to ask him. And here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and to him only belongs the best example, Mathal Mu'ala, is teaching us, and we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to first begin by mentioning his Asma al-Husna, his beautiful names, his best attributes. Then, to proceed with our need. And here, our need in this surah is to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect us from the evil of the one who whispers and who withdraws. Who whispers in the breast of an-nas. The fifth ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is now explaining who is that one, what he is doing. He is whispering our souls to, and he is inciting to evil. And this is the evil jinn, shayateen. As Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in Sahih, that there is no single person, or he said one of you, except that he has with himself a companion who has been assigned to him, meaning from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then the companions, they said, Ya Rasulullah, he said, yes. They said, even you, Ya Rasulullah. He said, yes, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made this jinn to embrace Islam. Fa-aslama is used word in Arabic, verb aslama. Some scholars, they say here that the meaning is that he embraced Islam, so he was after that only ordering and advising good, khayr. Because Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam فَلَا يَأْمُرُونِي إِلَّا بِخَيْرٍ. He was only ordering to me, telling me, advising me, suggesting me only good, khayr. So first opinion is that he became Muslim. And second opinion is which Ibn al-Izz in his Sharh al-Tahawiyyah, he said that he did not become Muslim, but he was overwhelmed, so he did not advise except but the goodness. Because he said the shayateen, they cannot become Muslims. But this is the difference of opinion, but the most correct opinion on this issue is that he became Muslim. Because aslama, as istislam, here has a meaning of al-Islam. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu kulli fi silmik ya. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, oh you who believe, enter into sin, as Imam al-Tabari explained, meaning Islam in full. And here the verb, here as Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, aslama has a meaning of al-Islam. But the benefit here, which is in, for us here, is that Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that every one of us has a companion from shayateen which incite us to evil. So it is for us to seek refuge in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from this companion. Because the main goal of this companion, this evil companion, is to incite us to commit kufr. Kufr, opposite to kufr, is al-iman. The meaning, the person who believes. What stands opposite to belief is disbelief, meaning kufr in Arabic. Disbelief can occur in three ways. It can be from the heart, disbelief, that meaning that a person has a doubt regarding something which is of mutawatir, something which is clear in religion, such as doubt regarding attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which are known to him by his fitra. Such as that Allah subhanahu is the one who sees everything, the one who hears everything, the one who is able to do everything. Doubts regarding Allah, regarding the Qadr, regarding the Yawm al-Akhir, the day of judgment. So all these doubts, if someone has in his heart, then this is a kufr of heart. And the who incites these doubts is a shaytan. Also kufr can occur in tongue, to say the words of kufr, to swear on the religion of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to mock anything of religion of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to say something disparaging regarding the beer of Muslim, to say something regarding even miswak, the tree which you use to brush your teeth, to belittle that tree. This is also kufr, and the one who does it, even if he believes in his heart that this is true, and it is a kufr of lovers, and it takes him out of religion. And the one who says is a shaitan. Kufr of deeds, to go and to be judged by the laws of Ta'gut. For example, if you live in the West, and something happens to you, and you want to go to court, if you do that by your limbs, this is the kufr of limbs. Even if you believe that this is wrong, and even if you think that this is just to take back my rights, this is disbelief. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَكَدْ كَفَرَ to disbelief in Ta'gut. وَكَدْ أُمِنُونَ أَنْ يَقْفَرُ بِهِ to disbelief in Ta'gut. And as Imam Sulaiman bin Abdullah said, the one who goes to Ta'gut for judgment, he believes in him. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala finally in his sixth ayah, in this surah, he said, min al-jinnati wa nas, of jinn and an-nas, and mankind. Here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us that we should seek refuge, and those who whisper evil to us, to our souls, are of two groups, group of jinn and group of humans. Here in this surah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala want that we seek refuge in him to protect our tawheed, to protect our belief that only he subhanahu wa ta'ala is to be worshipped and no one else. And we have two groups, group which are visible to us from jinn, as we said, that he whispers to us that we commit kufr, because this is his main goal, and we explained that short. Now we have another group of humans who are soldiers and even in some cases commanders of the jinn, who also incite to evil and munkar, such as today evil scholars of Ta'gut, Ansar of Tawagit, those who protect the evil leaders of kufr and misguiding, those who protect them by their fatwa. And they destroy the ummah. They destroy the Tawheed. They destroy it by destroying one important pillar of Tawheed, Kufr bit-Tawhid. Because in order to be Muslim, to dukhul al-Islam, to enter into al-Islam, as scholars they say, you need to make Kufr bit-Tawhid, to disbelieve in Tawhid. And disbelief in Ta'gut is the part of La ilaha illallah, the part there is no one worthy of worship illallah except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the negatory part. And the one who does not have kufr bi Ta'gut, he does not have La ilaha illallah. He only has the end of it, which is not sufficient for him to, in the beginning, be Muslim, to enter into Islam, not alone to live and die as a Muslim. And these scholars, these evil scholars, and their followers, blind followers, as Ibn Qayyim said, they donkeys, they teach that these rulers, that they are not Ta'gut, but they are Amir al-Mu'mineen, that they are the leaders which should be obeyed. It should be respected, it should be followed, and it is evil to go against them. So So not that they destroyed Kufr bi Tagut, but they become the Tagut themselves, and they become followers and the protectors of Tagut. And they destroy themselves, they destroy those who follow them, and this is the cancer of the Ummah. This is destroys the Ummah. Because La ilaha illallah in this process is destroyed in these people. And in order, in the context of this surah, this evil, this whisper comes from the humans and from the jinns. In order to destroy La ilaha illallah in the person, because every one of us is created only to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Nothing else, nothing more than that. And this is the epic, this is the highest goal, and this is, that's why we are created. And Allah SWT said, Inna shirka la dhulmun adheem. Verily, shirk is the greatest injustice, because this universe is built on justice, built on la ilaha illallah. And that's why the end of the world comes on this face of earth, no one will be of Tawheed, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to take to himself each and every muwahid. And only the disbelievers and the lowest of the low is going to be remembered this earth. That's why Ibn Kamil Jawziyah, he said, that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to destroy this earth and the whole universe, because there is no one left to worship him. There is no one left of La ilaha illallah. And inshallah, we are going to emphasize Kufr bi Tagut and believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala greatly, and this is our word, this is our message. Because Asluddin, the fundament of religion, is to say, Jtanibu bi Taguti wa Ibn Billahi, to stay away, to disbelieve, to go away completely from heart, from tongue, from the limbs of Tagut, and to believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to worship Him only, with the heart, with tongue, and with the limbs. And this is La ilaha illallah. This is message of all Anbiya, and this is the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As to finish, as Shaykh Abdurrahman Hassan said, تَحْكِيكُ الدِّينُ الْإِسْلَامِ وَأَسَاسُ تَوْحِيدِ وَرَأَسُهُ اجْتَنِبُوا بِتَاغُوتِ وَمُشْرِكُونَ. As Abdurrahman Hassan said, that establishment of religion of Islam, its fundament and its head is Kufr bi Tagut, in other words, to stay away from what is worshipped and one who worships it. And this is our message and this is our minhaj. And inshallah, we are going to finish this explanation of this short surah by these words. Subhanallah, bihamdihi, ashhadu an la ilaha illa anta, astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk.